Hi everyone! Today I wanted to kick off a new occasional series where I review books that have really helped me out as a developer. The one I'll start off with is one that I recommend to others all the time, Game Programming Patterns by Robert Nystrom. Quick note, this post was not sponsored and I bought this book with my own money. In programming, a design pattern is a repeatable way to solve a common problem. For example, maybe you have some functionality that you find yourself using over and over again with certain functions. You can use the decorator pattern to up your code reuse and make your code easier to maintain. I've read a few books on programming patterns, but this one is by far my favorite. Rather than cover all of the design patterns that see some use today, Nystrom chooses to cover only the ones he sees as the most helpful for the modern developer. I vastly prefer this over books that cover all the design patterns. While I appreciate the thoroughness, sometimes design patterns can feel a bit samey after a while. It also made the book more streamlined, meaning it was easy to read from cover to cover. Because let's be honest, when a tech book is 600 pages long, there's a good chance we abandon ship before we get to the end. Each chapter dives into one design pattern, explaining what it is, and giving some nice practical use cases for it as well as some sample code. One important feature of each chapter was that Nystrom also goes over whether a design pattern is not the right solution for a problem. One of the pitfalls of design patterns is that once you understand one, you can start to see it as the solution for every problem you run across. It's just like the old adage, when all you have is a hammer, every problem looks like a nail. Like the title implies, examples are put in terms of game development. So, methods might be attached to a barbarian character in a game, or the example might revolve around how to render a forest of trees without killing someone's frame rate. So what did I like about this book? First, I love the writing style. It is a good dose of humor without being too cute. The odd jokey aside makes for a great break in technical books. Also, I could relate to the examples better. Most books on design patterns use extremely abstract examples, like widgets, or use the same set of problems throughout the book. It's much easier for me to remember that flyweight is the forest rendering pattern and observer is the achievements pattern. Finally, the book didn't overstay its welcome. Many design pattern books are incredibly long and include chapters on patterns that most modern developers won't use that often. It's 400 pages long, which I assure you is extremely brief in the world of design pattern books. So who is this book for? First, it's for anyone who's interested in game development. The examples are extremely practical, especially when it comes to rendering. It's also good for anyone who wants a review of design patterns. When I read this book, it had been years since I'd read anything about design patterns, and it helped refresh my memory quite a bit. This book is also good for people just learning design patterns. The examples are concrete, the writing is clear, and it doesn't overwhelm the reader. So who is this book not for? I would warn away any novice developers. This has nothing to do with this book, though. I warn most extremely new developers away from design pattern books. So why would I not recommend design pattern books to someone who's only been coding for a few months? There's a few reasons. First, these books lean heavily on coding examples. There's only so much that pros can get across. This means you have to be pretty comfortable with coding because many different features of a coding language are going to be used in these examples. Second, there's a good chance that the examples are in a language you're not familiar with. The ability to read languages you don't code in comes with time and experience. Finally, I'm a big believer that patterns stick better after you've made a few mistakes. After coding yourself into a few lost weekends, you're more likely to take the time to learn how to solve a problem correctly the first time. Your mistakes also give you better context for how the pattern would serve you better in the future. You can get game programming patterns pretty much anywhere. I've included an Amazon link in the description, as well as a link to the book's website, where you can find more places to purchase it, as well as read it for free. And that's all I have for now. If you have any questions or suggestions, hit me up in the comments or track me down on Twitter. And thanks for watching!